Hello dear student, today we will start the online lecture series on various topics of chemistry. Today we will learn about the P block element. Our name of chapter is P block elements. So we know that there are four blocks in the periodic table, that is S block, P block, D block and F block. So among these various blocks, today we will learn about P block elements. So we know that p orbital having three orientation, that is px, then py and pz. We know that each orientation carry two electrons, therefore maximum electron carrying capacity for p orbital is 6. 6 electrons can be accommodated in p orbital, therefore there are six groups in the p block. So which are those group? That is group 13 to group 18. So we know that group 13, it is boron family. Then group 14, it is carbon family. Then group 15, it is nitrogen family. Then 15 group, that is nitrogen family. Then group 16, oxygen family. Then halogens, group 17, that is representative member is fluorine, and group 18, that is here in second period, neon. Okay, these are the group representative members of the p block elements. So general electronic configuration for p block is ns2 np 1 to 6. It means that last electron, valence shell electron, is present in p orbital. Means p orbital is valence shell, last electron enters in the p orbital, hence all these groups are placed in the p block. So we will discuss the brief common properties, and we will discuss thoroughly one by one group wise, that is group 13 to group 18. Let us have the picture of this p block element. So representative member of the family, we have first group 13, boron. Then boron family contain aluminium, then gallium, then indium and thallium. Then group 14, it is carbon family, carbon, then silicon, germanium, tin and lead. Carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. The symbol for lead is Pb. Then it is group 14, that is nitrogen family, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Then group 16, this is our group 13, 14, 15, then 16. Oxygen family, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. Then we have group 17, that is halogen family, representative member is fluorine, chlorine, then bromine, iodine and astatine. Then we have group 18. Group 18, it is नोबल गैस फैमिली फर्स्ट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव मेंबर हियर इट इज हेलियम एटॉमिक नंबर टू देन इन सेकंड पीरियड ग्रुप 18 दैट इज नियॉन आर्गन क्रिप्टॉन ज़ेनॉन एंड आयरन सो दिस इज आवर पी ब्लॉक लेट अस डिस्कस द एटॉमिक नंबर We know that atomic number of boron is 5. Then atomic number, once boron is 5, aluminium is 13. Because we know that this is our second period, this is our third period, this is our fourth, fifth and sixth period. When we are jump from second period to third period, there is jump of 8 electron, therefore 5 plus 8 is 13. Then when we jump from group period 3rd to period 4, there is jump of 18 electrons, therefore atomic number of gallium is 31. Again there is jump of 18 electron, therefore atomic number of indium is 49. And when we jump from group period 5th to period 6, there is jump of 32 electron, therefore atomic number of thallium is 81. Once we remember the atomic number of group 13, it is very easy to remember the atomic numbers of other group members. Therefore, atomic number of carbon, it is 6, nitrogen 7, oxygen 8, then fluorine 9, neon 10, silicon 14, phosphorus 15, sulfur 16, chlorine 17, argon 18, gallium 31, germanium 32, then arsenic 33, selenium 34, bromine 35, krypton 36, tin 50, antimony 51, tellurium 52, 53, then xenon 54, lead 82, bismuth 83, polonium 84, astatine 85 and 86, that is neon. This is all about the atomic number of group 13 to group 18. Now we will discuss the general electronic configuration. General electronic configuration. So we know that general electronic configuration of p block is ns2np1 to 6. Now for group 13 it is ns2np1, for group 14 it is ns2np2, for group 13 it is ns2np1, then 14 ns2np2, and it is successively so on ns2, np3, this is np4, np5 and np6. Means group 18 have filled p orbital, filled valence shape, and group 15 have half filled valence shell, because p orbital having maximum capacity 6, when it becomes there are 3 electrons for p orbital, it is half filled, and 6 electron, it is full filled. And we know that half filled orbital and full filled orbital have extra stability in their electronic configuration. So this is about the electronic configuration. Now we will have a brief discussion in the general periodic properties of these elements. So about the general periodic property, the elements in the group P block, there are some metals, some non-metals and metalloid. It is highly diversified block. So boron, it is non-metal. Then silicon, it is non-metal. Silicon, it is metalloid. Then arsenic. So there are some diagonal shape. Silicon, then arsenic, tellurium. Okay. Thanks. This is some diagonal shaped metalloids are there. Then here there are non-metal and here there are metals are present. So P block are forming the P pi bond, that is group. There are second period members. Then higher members of P block, that is metal, thallium, lead, bismuth, polonium. So then indium, tin, they are forming the P pi D pi bond. So P pi bond is formed by boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine, which is stable one. While D pi bond, it is weaker. It is formed by the some indium, thallium, lead, bismuth, tin, and so on. So again, there is some important concept, that is inert pair effect, that we want to study.